In this video, I'm going to teach you how to do a text effect to make your design stand out. You can make one that looks like this, and this is going to be all in Affinity Designer, and I'm going to take you step by step on how to do it. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to do some text effects. So you don't have to worry about graphics. This is just updating your text. So instead of having just boring text that doesn't do anything, I'm going to show you how to amp it up, how to make it just a little bit better so it stands out. I got this idea from Walmart. When I went there, I saw this t-shirt right here. And you can see it has that same diagonal text effect. I'm going to show you how to do that in Affinity Designer so you can do it. I'm going to do it just a little bit different. I'm going to move things around. So it's going to be real simple. I'm going to take you step by step so you can do it yourself with any text you want. So this can be used for different holidays, different hobbies, different kinds of t-shirts. So let's get into the tutorial in Affinity Designer right now. So here we are in Affinity Designer. I made my artboard to 4500 by 5400 and we're just going to start with some text. So the first thing you need to do is have some text in here. I'm going to go to the text tool right here and click on here and type, we're gonna just do best dad ever. You can use whatever text you want. I would say make sure that the font is something big and bold and the words are, you know, about the same size. That really helps. You don't want a very long word with very short words, right? So best dad ever, 4 letters, 3 letters, and 4 letters, pretty close. So I'm gonna use a thick font. And the font I'm going to use is Impact. You probably used this before. There you go. Nice, thick, bold font. And I'm just going to do best. And then hold down Option and Shift and drag to copy. And then I'll do dad. And then I'm going to do ever. Most people just stop right here and don't continue. So yours is going to stand out even better. So we can do it just like this, or we could do it the same size. I'm gonna drag this and make it the same size here, right there. Best dad ever. Okay, next thing we wanna do is to make an outline version of this. So we already have this one, best dad ever. Let's copy all of these. So I'm gonna hit Command J. You can see they copied all of them. And then this ever on the top, I'm gonna make a stroke. In fact, we're going to give all of them a stroke. Let's do all of them with a black stroke and let's do something thicker so that we can see about 7 in this case. There we go. You can see a lot thicker. I'm going to move these guys down this ever. Okay. Good. So you can't see the other ones real well, but we have this ever and this ever. Let's do the background ever with no fill. So if we do that, you can see if I turn this one off, it looks like that, right? Same thing with this. We got dad in the front, dad in the back, do no fill. Best in the front, best in the back, no fill, right? So you can see like that. So the next thing we wanna do is make our shape kind of cross through. So let's make this come down here. You can make any shape. I'm just gonna cross it here and then maybe cross it here. The way you want to do it is you want to cross a couple letters on the different levels, right? So this one's crossing that B and that E. Let's just complete it right here. So you can make it whatever you want. Whoops. There, see how it kind of crosses? Maybe I want to cross that A too, like that. Okay. Maybe that S there too, something like that. Whatever you want. Okay, so we're gonna fill this with a color just so we can see the difference. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is we have these words and we're gonna erase this from that. So I'll show you what I mean. So if we have this ever, which is on the top, this is the dark one. Let's multiply these. So I'm gonna do Command J. Like that. I don't think I'll need that many. I'll probably only need 4. Okay, so we do this ever and this curve. We'll put them together. Let's group them. So now you can see they're both together. And if I use this as erase, there it's going to erase the top part. So if I turn all of these off, you see that the outline is showing through. Isn't that cool? So let's do the same thing with Dad. So we'll turn these on again. So Dad and this one, just Command G group. And in that group, do erase. And as you guessed it, we're gonna do the same with Best and this and group. I only really needed three. I don't know why I hit it so many times, but let's do this and erase. Good. So now we can get rid of these. I believe we need those. And look at that. So cool, right? So that's a cool effect. But if we want to do and move things around, we'll do the opposite for the other one. So let's take this line here. Right? And make sure that we have that line here. Let's just do make sure we got that. Boom. We'll fill that with red. And then we'll do one on the bottom as well. So I'm gonna need two of these and two of these just because this intersects the Best and Dad, and this intersects Dad and Ever. So let me copy this one and this one, Command J on both. You can see they're right there. And so I'm gonna need the outline version of Ever, which is this one and this one. And we're gonna group those together and do erase. So we're gonna do the same thing for Best. So the Best one down here, the outline version of Best and this, we'll group those together and erase. I know it's getting really complicated now, right? The outline version of Dad here, and then these two, group those together. And these two should actually be grouped together too, inside of Dad, so that this can be erased. And now what we can do is we can move these things. So let's click on some of these things to move them. So this one is Dad. Look how it moves right there. You can give that kind of neat thing. Ever can be moved like that. This Dad can move like that, and so on. So you can kind of have that feel of it's disjointed, right? So that's how you can make it stand out. And if you want it on a black t-shirt, just reverse everything. Just go black t-shirt. Let's make it a lighter t-shirt so we can see. And we can change the color of these. So everything white. See that? And you may want to label these. So this can be Outline Dad. And so on. So I'm gonna color these white and I'll show you what it looks like. Cool, so that you can still add a line in there like I saw in Walmart. So let's do this. And let's make this line the same stroke size 7 that we had. Boom, oh, and white. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Right? And then this line here. May have to move that Dad one. I kind of moved that Dad one a lot so it crosses over. But the thing I like about this style is that you could color these. So the outlined ones, if you don't want them outlined, you could come in here and do, instead of outline, why not color them yellow, you know, or red. Maybe your dad's favorite color is white and red or something like that. You could still do that. So have fun with this. I personally like the outline version. So let's undo that. Yeah, so that's cool. So now this stands out. You could put some other things over here, but again, this is just text. We're not using any drawing or anything. We're just updating text. So hopefully this is really easy for you. We're just erasing the background and we're showing the other side. So we got two of these. Half of this is showing and half isn't on each side. So that's what the erase is doing. And then if you label these, you can easily figure it out, right? And look how cool that is. If you want to move these things, you can. Maybe you want to move ever just a little bit more, and you can do that like that. So have fun. You can do this with any text. So this could be best mom ever. This could be something about gamers. This could be anything. So use your creativity, come up with something cool. Use different lines. I went this way. You could have, you could go horizontally. You could do more than three colors. This could each be a different color. You could do red, white, and blue. The possibilities are endless. So be creative with this. This is just one way to do it. Of course, there's tons of different ways that you could do this, and you could do it with text as well as with objects. So if you use this technique like on a flag or on a shamrock or on something like that. So have fun with this. This is a cool way to make your design stand out, and it's not too difficult once you know how to use the erase feature and how to kind of blend two things. All we're doing is we're taking two things that are very similar, but then hiding one part of it and then showing it and then hiding the other part and showing it. And so that, I think that's really cool. So use this technique and make lots of designs and hopefully get lots of sales. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. If this video was super helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps in the algorithm. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there so that you can see all my videos. Before I leave, I wanted to leave with a question of the day. And the question of the day is this: how was your January 2022? Let me know in the comments. Was it better than January 2021? Did you just start print on demand? How are things going? Love to hear how you're doing with print on demand if that's what you're doing, or if you're doing any other business, leave that in the comments as well. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more videos about print on demand and how to design stuff, make sure to click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.